If you are looking to make character customization system in Unity in a simple and easy way, you found the right video. To keep everything simple, I create two scripts. Items Manager will contain a list of body part variations, for example, the hair variations. And the character save script will save and load the customization we did. In Items Manager script, we have two main functions. Swap item, it will swap game object from a list. Randomize, it will pick random game object from a list. Now, it's time to explain the code. We have public list of game object called item. This list will contain all the game object of specific items, for example, the hair. And we have public int current item index. We need this variable for two purposes. First, to have the index of the game object that we will activate in the list items. Second, we made it public so we can call it from the character save script. To avoid creating two functions doing the same thing for the left and right buttons, I decide to create one function called swap items. It will take parameter int direction. The value of direction will be 1 or minus 1. 1 for the left button and minus 1 for the right button. Inside swap item function, we will check if items list is empty or not. We will add direction value to the current item index, and because direction can be only 1 or minus 1, that means we can decrease or increase the value of current item index. Then we will check if the current item index is greater than the size of the items list. Of course, minus 1 because we always start from 0. If that's the case, then current item index we will set it to 0. I created this condition so we can loop whenever we reach the last item in items list, and we will do the same condition but if we reach the first item in the item list. But we have to set the value of current item index to the item.count minus 1. With those two conditions, we are sure that current item index will never be less than 0 and will never be greater than the item size. With this for loop, we will set all the game object inside items list to set active false. Then we will set the only one item of the current item index to set active true. With that, we will only have one item of the current item index to set active true. In randomize function, we will set the current item index to random value between 0 and the size of item list. And then we will set all the items inside item list to set active false. And finally, we will set the item of current item index to set active true. With that, we have randomly one item from the list items. In character save script, we need four reference of items manager script: hairstyle, shirt, pants, shoe. And we have two public functions, save and load, so we can call them from the button in the inspector. Luckily, Unity provides us with player prefs, so we can easily save and load int, char, float, etc. on the local machine. In save function, I just saved the current item index of hairstyle, shirt, pants, and shoe. In load function, I just load all the integer that we saved on the save function. In scene setup, I separate each body part's variation and I added items manager script to each. And here's how to do it. Select the hair game object, add items manager to it. Don't forget to lock the inspector so we can easily add the hair variation to the list. Unlock the inspector again, select the two buttons, and let's add the hair game object that contains items manager script to the event onClick. Then change the 0 to 1 in the left button and minus 1 in the right button. Do exactly the same to each body part variations. For randomize button, add 4 empty slots in the onClick event. One for the hair, shirt, pants, and shoe. And select randomize function for each. On player game object, add character save script and assign all the body parts variations. Finally, select save and load button, add on click event slot, in it add player game object, and call function save from character save on the save button and load function to the load button. Let's test and see. Everything works fine, from save, load, to swap items. If you find my tutorial helpful, consider subscribing and liking this video. See you in the next time. Peace.